Fraser, third power, video 2, prep for the first day.
When deciding which class to take, is the time of the class more important than the person teaching the class? Is the first day of class the first time you see the syllabus? Do you start reading the textbook only after class has started? If you have answered yes to any of these questions, then this video is for you.
First, to be a successful student, you must plan ahead, which starts way before you enroll in the class. Many students select their classes by the times and days, but ignore other useful details like who's teaching and his or her teaching style. If the person is currently teaching, try to sit in on one of his or her classes to preview the lecture and his or her style. If you cannot preview, then ask other students who have had this teacher for their impressions. Second, email the teacher or ask other students for a copy of the syllabus so you will know the demands of the class. For example, if the class requires oral presentations and you hate public speaking, then this is not a good fit for you. From the syllabus, make sure you understand the grading policy and how to earn the grade you want. Third, find the textbook, perhaps in the library, and preview it. Is it easy to read? How much does it cost? With information about the different teachers, teaching styles, and course requirements, you are now in a perfect position to select the best class for you. Fourth, do not take many classes back to back. You need a break because your brain needs a break. Brain rule: too much info in a short time will overwhelm your brain, preventing you from learning anything new. Instead of taking classes back to back, it is better to spread out your classes over many days. Do not overload your schedule. Make time to study every day in addition to living your life. Remember, for every 1 hour of class, you will need to study at least a couple of hours outside of class. Fifth, enroll in your desired class. Then email that teacher for the new syllabus to see if there will be any changes. Sixth, buy your textbook and other required materials. Ask current students if they want to sell the textbook cheaply at the end of the semester. Make sure it is the right edition. You can also buy textbooks and other supplies online to save money. Allow yourself plenty of time for shipping. Now get a head start. Before the first day of class, read your syllabus and the chapters to be discussed on day one. Reading a textbook in layers. Do not read from the first page to the last page like you read a novel. Instead, read small chunks of info at a time to prevent overwhelming your brain. You will save time and gain an overview of the topic. Reading in layers. This should only take you minutes, not hours. These minutes will help you in lecture later. First, start at the beginning and read only the headings and subheadings in the chapter you need. Second, start at the beginning. Repeat step one, adding pictures, graphs, tables, and reading the captions underneath. Third, read the chapter summary or review at the end of the chapter. The goal is to be familiar, not to understand. If you already understand, this is a bonus. Fourth, start at the beginning and read the regions around bold print words. The next step takes the most time, but is worth it. It helps the brain to process and remember the info. Fifth, on a clean paper, write your own definitions of the bold print words and pages where the words were found. Do not copy the book definitions. Highlighting. Many students over-highlight the book. You should only highlight short, important phrases, not the entire paragraph or page. Compared to reading in layers, highlighting is not as effective. Now you're ready for the next video, video 3, prep before class.